Okay, I'm back in the shop with these wonderful casements here that I took out of that opening over in South Tampa, but they were liquid nailed in, attached with liquid nails, and I had to take the Sawzall to it to get it out. It took a long time. So I've got some, you know, damage that I've done that I've got to undo, and my technique, you know, to get rid of, you know, the Sawzall blade stuff. And I got a big old one right there. I'm gonna put it on my table saw and cut off a little bit of both sides straight and glue a new piece on so that it, I can, you know, rehang the hinges. I mean, look, I cut into that with the Sawzall. It's, anyway, life is good. Let's see what happens. So here I am back on site, getting ready to glue a strip back on. And I've got my screws ready to go to screw it on here. But I was noticing here, look, this is the through tenon from this rail. And check out that big old gap there, man. It's interesting, you know, how that mortise is bigger than the tenon. For all you guys who want to do perfect work, I mean, I like doing perfect work too, but you know, these things have been working out for 100 years. Now there's a little bitty gap right there. So all right, well, let me put this piece on. All right, so I got these glued and screwed so that there's plenty of squeeze out out. Gotta go run an errand. Maybe it'll come back and it'll be dry. Maybe that guy will be done. Who knows? Oh, yeah. This is the opening they have to be rehung in. Clean all that up. Rehang it. Fortunately, looks like it's solid. Well, I've already done this side. Let me go ahead and turn this over so you can see. Yeah, I cut the sides of the window off because I butchered them with the Sawzall. So I put these new sides on and I gotta blend them in. I glued them on earlier. See, like, if you look here, you can see the screw holes. You know, you already took those out earlier, but I use the screws as clamps on the end. So anyway, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get this down close to the face where I want it with this. You know, this is just a regular plane, and once I get it ballpark, then I'll finish it off with this. And then I'll cut the ends off with my handsaw, wherever I'm at. Was at a 16th and then now it's at a 32nd. So I'm gonna switch it back to a 16th again. I'm gonna go on the other side. Trip it over my cord. switch it to a 30 second real quick. Nice. And Scott, if you go around the other side, I'm gonna plane this way if you don't mind putting your leg against this. So here's something cool. This is a Stanley number 4, and I've got the blade kicked. This is a, I don't know what the thing's called, but it can skew the blade a little bit. I've got more on this side than on that side, and that's so that I don't want to nick this face here, or I want to nick it as little as possible. So it's kind of sloped to the outside a little. Yeah, so it's a nice blend of modern and historic tools, I guess. You know, to kind of get you the results you want within a time frame that is useful. There we go. And if I have a little ridge or something, okay, I can still sand it, you know. I'm not going to worry about sanding it at this point, because I just have to get it back in the opening for today. That's, I could, besides Israel, do that anyway. Switch places with them. Come on this one. Come this direction. Somebody might ask, Steve, why are you using that plane? Well, I could use a block plane or other plane. I tend to use the plane that I actually have on me. I could even use a rabbit plane if I wanted, if that's all I had. I mean, is this called a Dutchman? I don't know if this is called a Dutchman or not. But it definitely is gluing a piece onto the edge and planing it down. Whatever you call that, that's what I'm doing. So then I got this here. I mean, it's pretty nice. It's pretty close. So now I'm just going to take the saw and cut these little ears off.
Call it an oops, because we only do this when something bad happens.
We do?
Measure wrong.
Yeah, well.
At least I do.
That's how you get good at stuff like this. You measure wrong. I'm just kind of gauging off the top of this. Try to get my cut. That's not bad. All right. Well, that's pretty good. So now I can take it over there and, well, probably gonna get it a little bit closer. I'm gonna set it in that thing. It's called a door jack. That'll hold that up, and then done with my table now, I can, I can plane it, and I'll try to fit it in that hole over there. Ta-da! All right, let's see if this thing's gonna fit or not. But he hands me the drill because he knows the drill. You know the drill? Let's see if this, no, it's still tight down there?
Yeah.
Let's see. See if the top fits. Oh, look. Hold on, let me act up here as a stop. Let's see. Is that? All right. Well, I got a little bit here. Okay, I got a. Take it up a little bit. Okay.
Get it out with a hammer.
Take a hit with a hammer. That'd be good. Okay. Yeah, I might have to take a little bit off that side. A little bit off that side. Okay. Is what I really like. Maybe we should leave these glue lines.
Again.
What do you think, huh?
I don't think Israel will.
You don't think he will?
Cool. That idea.
Well, it's cool. You can like see the reflection of the building in the glass. You can see the waviness of it. That's kind of nice. All right, so. Getting some of these hinges. It's like a, just gonna, already screwed them on to create a nice place to do my router to. I'm using a knife cut so that it'll be a place to put my chisel afterwards. So these other holes you see right there, those are the from the screws I used to clamp the piece of wood down. All right. Boom. Now that cut I made with a knife fits into that groove real easy. So it's easy to know exactly where to put your chisel. So you put the flat part against the outside with the mortise. So the knife is a real good locator. So I don't know if you guys can see at the bottom, but that's that sitting in that door jack. That's what that's called.
nice whack. Oops. Get that piece there.
And Israel runs over to yell at me.
You're hitting the... You're breaking the glass! What? No. There you go. What I want to do now is make sure I like totally miss and like jam this chisel into my finger. That's what I would, that's what you want to do right now. All right. So like, anyway, let's see if I can get this in here like that. So the router, you know, some people say, well, what, you know, maybe put a jig on there, you know, to do your router. Okay. Well, that would be right. That'd be all nice and good, but. What I'm using the router for more is a depth finder rather than, I mean, it does get out the most of it, you know what I'm saying, but it's just a real easy way to get that real fast, consistent depth. So, bam. So. All right, so let's put this back on, see how that works. Not bad. Got it. Now we got one more. Go this side here. All right, so what are we doing now? Got a little spacer here. What was my measurement? 3 and 6, right?
Yeah.
That hinge? Okay, so we're gonna get a 3 and a 6. Actually, we just do a 3. Boom. 3, and we're gonna come in 1 and 1/8. Start at the 2. Nice. Okay. And that's where I'm gonna put my hinge. Good. Alright, let me make my knife cuts on this. Let me sure. Alright, that's what I need. Here's my knife cuts. Create the boundary for my router. So, and then we'll hang this one, and then we'll use this one to mark where the others go, so we get them exactly right. All right, let's see if we can capture some of these antics. I just gotta get this hinge up here. I'm gonna use my foot to lift it. Oh yeah, there you go. All right, and, oh, perfect. Okay, so now we can judge where the other hinges go. See that? Oh yeah. Okay, so here's what I need to do. I'm holding it downstairs with my foot. So let's see, 1 and 1/8, is that what I have? Yeah, I'm in the right spot. I'm just gonna see if I can use my Vicks bit to put my hole in the right spot here. Okay, I'm only going to do one screw at a time, because if I'm wrong, it would be nice to get only one hole wrong. There we go. Cool. Now, let's get this guy. Oh yes, this has got to go. Yeah, see, that's where I probably did wrong. I'm gonna take this guy out. See if I can. Oh yeah, see, loosen it a little here, and I'm gonna put that one where it goes. That's about right. Got it. And my screw. But the problem is, once we get this on, now the bush is in the way, we can't close it. So, but. What we're really trying to do is just get our trajectory for where our hinges need to go. So just now I'll put a different hole here that will be in the right spot. See how that works? So you don't always want to do the all three holes at the same time, because especially in a situation like this, because too many variables, you want to be able to make sure you get it in the right spot. Now I'm gonna, there, mark my hinge boundaries, my mortise boundaries there. And that'll be it for now. All right, let's see if this thing closes. All right. Oh man, it's so close. We got the hinged. Where's it hitting? It's hitting over here. Hitting at the bottom. Okay. I think that might be the only spot. Here, hit again? Right in there somewhere. Okay. Well, I'm gonna get that hand plane out and see if I can't adjust it.
All right, get the hand plane out.
All right. That gum bush. Let's see if this is gonna stay still enough. There we go. And that's what I really want to do, is move around a whole lot. Getting there. Oh man, so nice. Give it a little push. There you go. Okay, almost there. Let me adjust the blade a little. Really nice. Just a little bit of fun. Love it. Oh yeah. That's it's only sticking at the very Yeah, it's the bottom that's sticking now, and that's...
Let's get a strip there to go.
What's that?
Let's get it all sanded down, it'll be fine.
Should be good. All right, Scott, I'm not going to lie, man. I'm really kind of excited, simultaneously disappointed on how easy this was in comparison to the other one we just did. I mean, Anyway, so I guess I'm gonna just going to sand this real quick and kind of blend in the bottom. But notice how I'm going to sand toward the inside of the door so as not to compromise my glue joint. I'm going to do it on both sides. That's gonna look really good, you know. I think, you know, once we're done, I might as well go ahead and sand a little bit here. But I think the on the other side, I've got some like Arbitron repairs to do. But this is gonna be a nice blend right here. So like somebody might wonder, what about, you know, stuff like this? Okay, well, I guess that we will Arbitron that. Yeah, that'd be a nice fill there, but that was broken before, you know. So yeah, same thing with the rest, like these other, like this right there. That's an old nail hole from. Like a huge, this came out of a floor joist, right? So I guess that was a nail hole, you know, taking walking lessons for me.
No, I did a lot better than you did.
Well, you're much more adept at that walking technique.
Yeah.
So anyway, but that's going to be it for this one. Cause she's, we had to add these sides on, you know, because of the damage I did sawzalling it out, but it should be really nice now, you know, fixing that little guy. So. Yeah, so she's swinging really good now. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's real nice. Hear that sound? What that is, see that? That white line right there, it's a weather stripping we put on, and it's a nice, soft, subtle, supple silicone bead that closes up against. So nice.